I'm going to do that by introducing you to somebody you all probably already know. One of the Vancouver International Bhangra Celebration Society's board of directors, Mr. Mo Daliwal.
Years ago, we started off as a competition. And at the time, we started that way because we didn't know what we were doing. We had no clue as to what we were trying to accomplish, but we had an instinct, we had a feeling. What we were trying to do was we were trying to get our community, the Punjabi community, to reimagine itself, to look at itself in a new way. So we kicked it off with a competition that was great, that went well for a while. But after a time, we felt like we were kind of trapped in that conversation. All anybody ever wanted to talk about when it came to the City of Bhangra Festival was how many teams are performing, where the team's from, who placed first, second, third, who should have placed first, second, third. And that was 90% of the conversation. So we basically made the best decision of our lives and we got rid of the competition.
Yeah, but like competition like Bhangra Idols or like how VIBC used to was a platform for people to do what they wanted to do, right? Teams like Bhangra Empire, teams like UBC Girls, and to take folk and fuse it with modern. But now there's such a big divide of, okay, we're folk, we're modern, this is not Bhangra, this is this. So how do we as a community, like how do we get past that so that we can work?
I think we get past that, actually, by dividing the categories. Wait, why does Bhangra have to be one thing?
When Bhangra comes, there's categories coming together. Girls are competing against boys. Sometime girls' team came first place. I saw so many competitions. Even one time I was a judge in Bhangra Idols. I think won the girls' team. They came first place. It's Jawani girls.
Yeah.
They beat the boys' teams.
Yeah. Our team.
So
spent
today
years
is like.
So how long have you guys been? How long have you guys been doing
Bhangra?
As our team or
as
a separate
team?
Both.
As
our team?
We've been
about two years. Two years.
Yeah,
yeah. 2 years. As our team?
2 years.
Yeah. 2 years. But separately, we've all done between like five to ten.
You know, tension that a lot of teams have, you know, we can't talk with these people, or you know, you're in this team and you can only talk with these people. Another thing that we had was more festivals throughout the year, so we can keep it ongoing and not just, you know, just 10 days of VIBC and people forget about, you know, 360, whatever it is, right?
So, and then we're back, City of Bhangra.
Yeah, and then, you know, the week before, you're like, oh, you know, let's get back into it. So, you know, more evenly spaced out, or have it throughout the year.
Ceremony. Well, I'm ceremonies chair for many, many events. But I did 10 years of putting together the multicultural shows at the Queen Elizabeth. We had sometimes 80 groups of different nationalities. And the goal was that they had to do their thing, their 3 minutes or 5 minutes performance, but they could only participate if they came to the rehearsals. And it was set for the first half who were in it, and another time, many rehearsals for the second half. And you had to mix up. You weren't allowed to hold or dance beside anybody that was from your group or your nationality. And they had to do a finale of the first act.
Or bringing awareness, at least, I would say at the very least, to Bhangra by people that may not have ever known what it was. But I think at the same time, you're in doing that, but are you negating people that, like our own community, from participating in these events by not having them in places where maybe they'd be able to act?
So we need to engage more on a personal face-to-face level.
Yes, like WestJet. You ask the CEO of WestJet, he says, the employees don't work for me. He goes, I work for the employees.
Let's say like a jam-packed 3-4 day festival, and then you have events throughout the year that are keeping the community engaged and together, I think that would be more worth it than people exhausting their manpower over 2 days.
And what I'm also hearing is that last year expanded out into Surrey and now they're saying Abbotsford, against capacity issue. So how about the idea of maybe forming like a Surrey chapter and an Abbotsford chapter, so work together, that they can do their own programming and you can do more capacity that way?
Not to be the negative guy, but what's the motivation for everybody to work together? Like, what is the end goal? I love working together with all these guys. Like, I'm friends with everybody here. But why would we want to work together for the sake of Bhangra? Like, what is the goal?
Okay, I'll open it up. Well, if I can answer your question, if we were to look at, like, this festival and the concept of Bhangra just beyond the dancing,
and like look at it as like, what is this community trying to undo? Like, what are some of the conceptions? What are some of the barriers between communities that we're trying to break down? Whether they're stereotypes or, you know, economic or structural inequalities. If we think about it that way, with Bhangra dancing and the competitions being a big component, I think a way for people to work together for a common goal might be that common goal, which is then filtered down through different events throughout the community that are keeping people engaged.
The way I see it over the years, in especially in the foreign countries, whether it's Canada or England or wherever, originality, actually the Bhangra was actually a toll. And it is still the formation in India if you go into the Punjab. As we come into this country, we wanted to involve our younger generation, and we did not have that many tollies who actually knows what to play and so forth. And the modern came into the picture because we can pick up the songs for many movies and that kind of stuff, so it was easier. The both are important as long as we are promoting the Bhangra or our community or our culture, whatever. The both are equally important.
Very rare. And you dancers can attest to this. We don't get to have these kind of conversations about dance and Bhangra and our art. So the point of the today is going to be, and how today is going to be actually a successful conversation, is that we carry forward with action and that we don't just let this conversation dissolve today, but we actually do and move forward with it. And we as VIBC will ensure that that does happen, but we need all of your help and your input to make that happen. So I feel so good about today. I'm being really honest with you, and I was speaking to some of you on the phone. I was nervous. I was like, I don't know, people are not going to want to talk, they're not going to spend their Sunday afternoon discussing this.
That's the first time you ever said, I was nervous.
You oh, I know in my life, across, probably ever.
You don't come across as a nervous person.
This is true. Nervous is not part of my vocabulary.